Hi guys, my name is Vivek and in this video tutorial I am going to talk about dynamic lookup in Informatica. So over the last few days I received few requests where people wanted to understand what are the constraints with static lookup and what particular scenario is being catered by dynamic lookup. So as I have done in my previous tutorial, I am going to explain this with a very straightforward simple example. I'm going to first of all show what are the restrictions with static lookup or what is the need of dynamic lookup, and then I'll explain how it is implemented in Informatica. So as we have learned or we have seen in our previous tutorials, I'm going to explain this with a real world practical scenario that you can explain in your interview as well, that okay, these are the type of problem statements that you catered through dynamic lookup. So let's go ahead and see that real quick. So every organization has an employee table. I have kept my employee table pretty short and compact so that you can grab the concept easily. So my employee table has three columns: ID, name, salary, and Vivek, Sam, and Nina are the part of the organization, and their respective salary is highlighted in the rightmost column. So every day new people join in the organization, their data will be inserted, and for the existing employees the data can be updated. For example, during the appraisal season, Vivek, Sam and Nina, based on their performance, their salary will be changed. So today, the flat file that I received today, I load this data on a nightly basis as a part of batch job. So the flat file that I received today, it has three rows. The salary of Vivek has been updated, possibly his designation was changed. Then we have two new employees, Rio and Roger. So if I talk about my conventional static lookup cache, this particular scenario can be easily handled using that. How it will work? As soon as we run the workflow in Informatica, it will build the cache. The cache will have three records: the details of Vivek, Sam and Nina. When we run our workflow, it will identify if Vivek already exists in the cache or the database. Yes, it does. It will go ahead and update its salary. When it validates for Rio and Roger, it will not find their records in the cache and it will go ahead and insert them. So it's going to be a straightforward process. It's going to run neat and clean. There will be no failure. Employee ID is our primary key here. But let's take another scenario which will not be catered with our conventional static lookup cache. Let's see first the scenario and then I'll explain how it will be tackled using dynamic lookup. So we have our same employee table, and as I mentioned, as soon as we run the workflow, the first thing that happens is the cache is built. So before any data processing starts, the cache is built, and every time a row passes through that lookup, instead of going and seeing on the table what is the data, it goes and sees that data in the lookup cache. So let's see this particular example in which our static cache will fail. Now the challenge is, in my flat file that I have received for tonight, I have two rows for Rio. So what may have happened is that in the morning, Rio is a new employee, his data does not exist in my employee table. In the morning when Rio joined, the data that we got in the file, that his salary was 700, but Rio was not happy about it. He said that during the interview the actual salary offered to him was 900 and not 700. So there was a discussion and negotiation. After that, his salary was finalized as 900. So we received another row in our flat file, which is the current row, and his salary is 900 according to that. And another guy, Roger, has joined, his salary is 600. So if we run this with our conventional static lookup, as soon as we run the workflow, our cache will be built. It will have three rows. When we get the first row, it will treat Rio as a new employee and his salary will be 700. When the second row is processed, this is where the problem will come. Although Rio is the part of the organization now and his data has been inserted in the table, but Informatica does not know that. It has already built the cache and it's not going to go ahead and look in the database. So it's going to think, okay, Rio with employee ID 4 does not exist in my cache. That means it's a new employee. Let me go ahead and insert this record in my table. As soon as it will try to insert this record in the table, on the database end, we will get a primary key constraint violation and our process will fail. So the challenge here is, because the cache was built at an initial stage and we had duplicates in our flat file, the primary key of my target table was duplicated in the flat file. I need to either I capture the latest data from my flat file, or there is another way to handle this, and that way is using dynamic lookup. How dynamic lookup will work is, so as soon as the row is inserted in my employee table, my cache will also be updated. It is now aware that Rio is an existing employee with salary 700. So next time when the next row comes with Rio as salary 900, instead of inserting, it will know that, okay, this is an existing employee. I don't have to go ahead and insert this. I can update the row. So the data will be updated. The salary of Rio has been changed from 700 to 900 thanks to dynamic lookup. If it was a static lookup, in that case, if it was a static lookup, it would have tried to insert a new row because it was not aware that Rio has already been inserted. And when for the final row, when it will try to insert Roger, since it does not exist in the cache, it's going to insert Roger as well. So we won't have any failures. Our data will be inserted correctly without any issues. Now, someone can ask that, okay, why don't we consider dynamic lookup for everything? It's more intensive because every time after every row, it has to rebuild your cache. So only when it's really required or you foresee a situation like this, you should use dynamic lookup. Otherwise, static lookup is sufficient. So let's see how we will implement this in Informatica. So I have logged in into my Informatica designer. I'm creating a mapping M dynamic lookup. I've already created my flat file. So this is my flat file that has three rows. So guys, I would like you to pay a little extra attention right now when we use the dynamic lookup. So this is the target table, employee underscore dynamic cache that we'll be using as a lookup. So right now it's a normal static lookup. You need to change a couple of properties to make it dynamic. I only need the ID, so I'm going to delete these two columns. And when we go to property tab and we scroll down a little, we will see this option, dynamic lookup cache. We have to check it in order to make it dynamic. So what does the description says? It says that it updates lookup cache with unfound or new lookup values. So that's what it meant, that every time we witness a change, it's this cache is going to get updated. Now let's go back to our ports. If you see, a new port has been inserted, new lookup row. Earlier we had only ID, and I will explain the significance of this port in a moment. First, let me drag my columns because we have not inserted the lookup condition. That's fine. Just click OK. Drag our source input columns to lookup. I'm going to change the name of the port as IN input underscore ID. Make the data types consistent. For some reason, it took it as integer. Let's go here, save it. Now let's add the update strategy. Though you necessarily don't require update strategy in this particular case, but just to keep it simple, I'm going to add an update strategy. Now, what is the relevance of this new lookup port? So if the data does not exist in the cache, so the integration service, it assigns value to the new lookup row based on the lookup outcome. So if this particular row that has come, for example, Rio will come for the first time, Rio with employee ID 4 and his salary is 700, when he will come for the first time, it's an insert. So integration service will assign new lookup row as 1. For every insert, it will assign new lookup row as 1. And if it's an update, it will assign the value as 0. So if new lookup row is equals to 1, I'm going to do a DD insert. Otherwise, I'm going to do DD update. And I'm going to add the target. So the mapping is valid. I'm quickly going to generate the workflow. So the workflow has been generated. Let's just make sure that all the connections are correct. So in the lookup, I have to specify the connection. So let's run the mapping in debugger mode and understand how the dynamic lookup is working. So here I have my first row, Rio with the salary 700 and his ID is 4. So as of now, this row does not exist in my table, neither it exists in my cache. So it should go ahead and insert the row. So let's go ahead. So if you see the new lookup row is 1, that means this is a new row. It will go ahead and insert it. At the same time, it will insert this particular data in its cache as well. So right now, I got an insert here with Rio. So the next row is also Rio, but his salary has been updated to 900. Now, if this was a static lookup, it would have tried to insert the row in the target and got a primary key violation. Let's see what will happen since it's dynamic. Since it's dynamic lookup, it understands that this row has been inserted in the past in the cache. So I got new lookup row as 0, and instead of inserting it, it will go ahead and update the data. And Roger is a new employee, so it will go ahead and insert Roger. And I have another row for Vivek. His salary has been changed to 600. So this will also, the new lookup row is 0. That means it's going to go ahead and update it. So that's how it's going to run. So the second part where Rio, the data for Rio was updated, it would have tried to insert the data if this was a static lookup cache, and it would have failed with
primary key violation that has been tackled through dynamic lookup, because as soon as a new row was inserted, it went back, inserted that data in the cache as well. So let's see if everything went fine. Let's go ahead and run it. Right now we ran it in the debug mode and discarded the target data, so we won't see anything. So this is the data that we should see. Now let's go ahead and run the job. It succeeded. Four rows were affected. Let's see what happened here. So we got Rio with 900, Roger with 600, and Vivek with 600, which was the expected result. So just to recap real quick, dynamic lookup is required in certain conditions where we expect that the input data may have redundant primary keys, which will result in failure if you use static cache. It's not a replacement of static cache because it's doing the additional overhead of writing to the cache every time a new row is encountered. So if you already know the kind of data you are expecting, use the static cache and not the dynamic cache. But if you foresee that there is a possibility that you may get data with same primary key multiple records as a part of the batch file, go ahead and use dynamic lookup. So that's all for this session, guys. Do drop in your comments in case you want me to create any more videos. Please let me know. I'll try to create more such videos. And do like and subscribe to my channel. It actually encourages me to make more such videos. Thanks a lot, guys, for your time, and have a good day.